Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to start a new series on this channel, which is called the Word Automation in UiPath. We already have completed a series on Excel automation in UiPath. In case you haven't already watched, I will put the links in the description so you can refer that. Having said that, now let's get started with the Word Automation in UiPath. To start with, what I have done in my folder, in my D drive, data, if you would see that I have a folder which is called Word file, and there I have kept a sample file which is a doc file, sample.doc. If I go to the file, you would notice that I have taken some of the content from Wikipedia, and this is the content, let's say, we want to use in the UiPath Studio. Okay, so I'll just hit a quick save, close this one, and this is the file which we want to read. Okay, now let's go straight away to UiPath Studio and see how we can start. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to go and hit on a new process. This I will call as Word Automation. It is always a good practice to provide a sensible name and provide the good description. Okay, so I would just say it is the Word Automation for my first video and hit create. Okay, so I am in my UiPath Studio. I will just go here and click on open the main workflow. This will open a sequence for me where I can write the automation. Okay, so let's start with the Word Automation. So first of all, to start with the Word Automation, if you go to the project, you should have the Word dependency added to the project. Now, what do I mean? If I go to the activities and let's say if I just search for Excel, right? So assuming that I'm writing an Excel automation. So you could see that I am getting all the activities which are related to Excel automation. Why that is coming? Because in the property, I have UiPath.ExcelActivities added. If you see here, I do not have the Word Automation activity added here. So that is why I am not getting any activity for the Word Automation. So if I search here Word, you would see I am not getting anything, right? So the first thing is we need to go to the project and we need to add the dependency of the Word activity package. How do I do it? It's absolutely simple. Go to the dependency, right click on it, click on manage. You will be in the project dependency panel. Here in the all packages, this you will get all the packages, right? Search here UiPath.Word. Okay. And you would find something which is called UiPath.WordActivities by UiPath, right? So I will just click on it. You would see different versions which are available. I stick to the latest one. And click on install. Once done, you have to click on save. Now what is happening? It is saying restoring dependencies, which means now my solution is getting ready for the Word Automation. Just wait for this setup to complete. Once completed, you would notice that the UiPath Word Activities pack is added here. Now if I go to the activities and if I now search here Word, you would see that I am getting in the available, I am getting all the activities which are related to the Word Automation. Okay, now to start with the Word Automation, if you are a bit familiar with the Excel series, to start with Excel, reading of the Excel, if Excel is installed on the machine, we use something which is called Excel application scope. Similarly, to do the Word Automation, we have something which is called the Word application scope, right? So if you go here in the Word, you would see there is something which is called Word application scope. Now, what does this mean? This application scope will provide a kind of an environment for all the Word related activities. So all these activities, whichever you are seeing on the screen, would be working only in the Word application scope. So for example, today I want to read some text, right? So if I just drag and drop this read text here, you would see that I am getting an error which says this activity is valid only inside the Word application scope. Fine. So Word application scope, if you see here, this also mentions that opens a Word document and provide a scope for the Word activity. So all the Word related automation would be coming in the do block. Fine. Now, once I have the Word application scope, the next thing it will ask me that you tell me where is the document path. Now I can simply click on this folder button, browse for file, and let's go to the D drive where we have kept the file, right? So I go to the D drive, in the data, Word file, and open. Now this is a string, right? Now this is a string, which means that I can always use a string variable here, something like this, right? And I can pass this path here, and then we can use the variable here. You can also use this path as an argument. This would be useful when you are writing a bigger piece of automation and word automation is a small part of it. So in that case, this can be an argument. In case you are not sure how does a variable and argument work, I have provided the links here. You can refer those videos and that will clear. So the objective here, so the idea is the word application scope will expect you to provide a path which is in a form of string. Once your word application scope is provided with a path, the next thing you want to do is go to the properties and check out what are the properties available. This is important when you are doing a real-time automation. The first thing is the word application scope, right? Always make sure that you change the file name, because in case of exception, this would help, right? So word application scope for sample doc, because the name of the document for me is sample. Fine. File path, we understand. Private, if I check, it would not log this error in the web browse. So this is a common property for all the activities. Now coming to the options which I have three options: autosave, create if not exist, and read only. Now, for any of the activity in UiPath, if you want to know what that does, you just simply right click on here and you click on help. It will navigate you to the official documentation of UiPath, which is docs.uipath.com, and we can directly read that what this option are. Let me quickly tell you what exactly it is, right? So the first option is autosave. What it means? So for example, in the word application scope, I have put five activities. Now, after each and every activity, if you want the word document to be saved, you would tick on this, which is called autosave. Now, what would happen if selected? The document is saved each and every activity. So once each and every activity is executed, the document is automatically saved. What happens if I uncheck this one? If I uncheck this one, the changes are saved only if all the activities inside the word application scope are executed. Which means, so for example, if I go here and I'm just putting some two activities here. As of now, if you go to the word application scope in the properties, this autosave is checked, which means that after this activity, it will save the work file. After this activity, it will save the work file. But if I go and uncheck this one, what would happen? That once all the activities are executed, at the last, this would be saved, right? So depending upon your requirement, you can always go and check and uncheck this one from the word application scope. So the by default, it was checked for me. Now, the next thing is create if not exist. As the name suggests, what happens if the file which I have provided is not available? Do I want to automatically create it or I do not want to create it? In case you want to create it, you can always go ahead and tick on this tick box which says create if not exist. Okay, so if I go to the documentation now, a new Word document is created if the file is not found, right? If not selected, an error occurs if the file is not found at the specified path. So let me quickly show it to you by a demonstration. Okay, so as of now, we are saying that Word application scope is there. And okay, let's try to read it. And let me just go here and put a message box. Okay, in the message box, as of now, we are not reading anything. I am just saying that reading is done. Fine. So simple activity, Word application scope, keeping it with the default settings, create if not exist is true, and here it is which says that reading is done. Now if I go here and I say run the file, okay, so the robot is here, it will try to read the word file, and as you can see, the word file is here which is shown up on the lower panel, and now we should get a message box which says reading is done, right? So that was a straight away automation and it was successful. Now what happens if I go here and I just rename this file? Okay, I'll just go here and rename this file to rp_sample. Fine. Now if you go here and you would see that d:wordfile:sample-doc, right? Sample doc is not available on the path. And here I have checked this one which says create if not exist. So now let's try to go ahead and run this file. Okay, Now let us see what happens. So we do not have the sample file available in the folder, and the file is also ticked, right? So again, I have got a message which says reading done, right? Now if I go back to the folder, you would notice that the robot has already created a file which is called sample.doc. Why it has created? And by default, it does not know that what content I need to put. So the file is absolutely blank. Okay. So if you see here, this is created because I have ticked on this option which says create if not exist. Bad. Let me go back again here and I will delete this file here. Okay. Now sample.doc is not available here. I go to the Word application. In the properties, you could see that this is not available. I am doing some operation here. And let's try to go here and say run the file. Okay, now I can see that the file is not available and UiPath will try to read it. And I am telling UiPath that you don't need to create also. So that's where you get an exception. There is an exception which has been thrown and the message says the d:wordfile_sample.docs does not exist, right? Which says that you do not have the file available. So this exception is coming because we have not clicked on this one, which says that create if not exists, right? So depending on your automation, use this flag wisely. Okay. Now what is the third property? The third property is the read only. So what does this say? If selected, the Word document is opened in a read only mode. This can be used if the document is locked for editing or to avoid make any changes when only needing to read the data. Fine. So I hope you understand. For example, if I have a file which I only want to read the data and I do not want to make any changes. So that is where I would just go here and click on this property which is called read only, right? This would be also useful if the file is in a read only mode or it is locked by some other user. Fine. So if you just want to read the data, you can always use this option read only. So this will only read the data. You won't be able to change anything in the Word file. So if you have a requirement, you can always go and check this option as well. Okay. So before we proceed, let's have a quick recap of the Word application scope. So we have seen that Word application scopes open a document and provide a scope for the other Word activities. When this activity ends, the document and the Word application is closed. If the file does not exist, a new document is already created. We have just seen that, but this works only if the property is specified in the true. Now the last one, this activity can only be used if Microsoft Word application is installed on your machine. For me, I have the Microsoft application installed on my laptop, so I'm able to use the Word application scope. I hope now you understand the Word application scope and all of its property. Now let's move forward and try to read the content of the Word file which we have placed. Let me quickly show you how exactly can we use a variable to pass the Word file path. Okay, so I have in the variable, I have created this one. I go to the Word application. I will just copy the complete path of the Word file, which is DE data Word file and this. I go here and in here, I just pass this path like this. Okay. So now instead of passing the path here, you can always pass the variable also. str word path. This can be variable. This can be argument. The only thing is it should be of the type string. Now, how do I know? If you go here in the file path, if I just keep my mouse, you could see that the in argument says string. Right. So that means you can use a variable, you can use an argument, or you can directly pass the path here. Okay. So now my word path is reading the file from the RPA sample. So for this tutorial, let's try to read this file, the content, all of this, and print it in a message box. Okay. So I just go here to read the text. Let me go in here and say word. And let's see if I have got something to read the text, right? So most of you would have guessed it correctly. The activity is read text. I just drag and drop the read text here. And you could see it's a simple activity which only works inside the Word application scope. Yes, I am inside the Word application scope. So Word application scope is asking me, you tell me where do you want to save the data, right? Because to pass the data from one activity to another activity, I would need to store the data somewhere, right? So What do I want to do? I want to print this content in a message box, right? So in a message box, I want to show the content. Now I want to pass the data from here to here. So I need to store it somewhere. So that somewhere is nothing but a variable. So you go to the read text, click on the properties. Output is a text. Now, how do you create a variable? You just go here. Easy way is hit Control plus K and I say str underscore data, right? Now the UiPath will already created a variable for me, which is called str underscore data, which is a string and the scope is inside this one. Now, what would happen? UiPath will go read this data and store all this data into the data str data variable. Now, all I have to do is just pass this data in the message box. If I go to the read text, you can again see it has only got one property, which is called the output. Where do you want to store the output? I want to store the output in a string variable. So passing the string variable here and writing it in the message box. Let's try to save the automation. I'll go here and you can keep this file open. Still, UiPath would be able to read it. Go here and run the file. Now what is happening? File is available. It will try to read the data and show the data in a message box. Okay. So as you can see, I was able to successfully get the data in the message box, right? If I just compare it with the file, yes, all the data is available in the message box. Now I can use this data in the other pieces of automation. So that is how you use the Word application scope and the read text activity. I hope now you understand how to use the Word application scope, what are the prerequisites, and what are the things you need to take care when you are working with the Word application scope. Okay, so that is all for this video. I will wrap this video here. In the coming videos of this series, we'll try to explore more and more activities with the Word automation with UiPath. Thank you for watching. If you like this video and found this video insightful, please subscribe to the channel and happy automation. Thank you.